Honorable Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, Incidence Cause Number 027-2020, versus the Attorney General, Martin Okoth Ochola, Wislenga Nanizi, Haj Baraza Sulaiman, Fred Ahimisiwe, Lieutenant George Mwonda, and Kato Arafa.
Please, Your Worship, my name is Meda Lubega Segona. I appear for the applicant, together with my learned friends, Mr. Anthony Wameli and Mr. Ronald Mafari. For the respondents, I do not know which ones, but Mr. Peter Masaba, Ms. Senyonjo Madina. I want to assume that they represent all the respondents. And Madina Senyonjo appear for the respondents.
We have the applicant in court.
So the applicant is in court. The respondents are all defiantly absent. This matter was worship fixed. The matter was fixed for now for hearing. An affidavit of service sworn by Mr. Njoroge Githinji Martin was filed in this court on 18th August. Indicating service onto the respondents together. Actually, there are two affidavits. Filed in this court on 18th August.
Answer, I see one. I see the one of
Wanuru Joseph. No, this is another one, the worship filed on court record. In the event that it cannot be traced, I would gratefully submit this one after my submission. And it attaches the notes of motion received by the respective respondents on 13th August, service was effected, and 14th August, service was effected on to all respondents who have not filed their respective replies if they intend to oppose the application.
I see affidavits and replies.
I am not privileged to access any.
If they were filed less than an hour ago.
In the event.
Counsel for the respondent, you have not served your colleagues?
Your Worship, we have served the counsel for the applicant simply because this matter was brought on short notice. And some of the respondents are not resident in Bali. Given the rules of pleading, we have 15 days to respond to the actual pleading, which has not lapsed. So we are still within time to file replies to this application. And some.
I see affidavits in reply for the respondent, says for the second respondent. If you have them, can you now serve the council now that you know that they are here? This is the applicant's stance of this argument, the applicant's reply.
We are confirming whether we have all that. We have all, I'm told, apart from the second respondent, Martin Kotochola, and we do not know whether he intends to file or not. And I do not even know whether he has instructed counsel, and therefore whether they speak for him. And if not, we would apply to proceed ex parte as against him. Maybe we would have that clarified.
Yes, counsel, you may. Do you have instructions to represent the second respondent?
We have full instructions to represent all the respondents. And I would request counsel for the applicant to serve us with that affidavit of service as proof of service so that we can tell whether all the respondents were served. Because to the best of our knowledge, none of them are served. So we humbly pray for an affidavit of service.
Well, Your Worship, whereas I do not have problems giving him a copy of the affidavit of service, I don't know for how long my brother has practiced law.
but I know for a fact that by the time somebody gives you instruction to appear, he has been served.
Then did you mean so, Council Masaba?
Pardon?
If you have been instructed by a second respondent,
well,
then did you mean that he's aware of this case?
Being aware and being served are two different things. We are talking about service.
You are saying he has not
this
been served?
This has got nothing to do with my years of practice. It is prudent that he serves us with an affidavit of service, unless he doesn't have one. But if he has one, it is prudent that he gives us that affidavit. Because after this reply, this cute service on some of the respondents.
Well, to avoid wasting more time, since there is proof of service, unfortunately, I'm now being asked to submit my copy to court. My brother may access the same from court record. Now, dispute on service can only be again by affidavit, not evidence from the bar. I submit very strongly that instructions.
Just a minute, counsel. Was the second respondent served?
Yes.
Your Worship, paragraph
4
of the affidavit of service states that on 14th August 2020, I proceeded with the same to the second respondent officer, Inspector General of Police officers located at the police headquarters in Naguru, Kampala, where I met the OCRO-OR to whom I introduced myself and purpose of my visit, handed over copies of the same, and he acknowledged receipt, endorsed the copy as hereto attached. So there was service on the gentleman. That is how he instructed, I believe, Able Counsel, Mr. Basava, to represent him. It pays to be honest to courts where you are practicing as an officer. If my brother has any reason for not having filed a reply, I think the best practice is to indicate his intention to file one. But since he has not indicated his intention to file one, we may take it and submit that the Inspector General of Police is not interested in defending this matter. Subject to your resolution of that particular issue, we shall make our submission. Otherwise, we pray that you order the proceedings ex parte against Mr. Martin Okoth Ochola, IG.
Your Worship, in a brief response to the Council's prayer. I humbly submit that evidence by way of notes of motion is by way of an affidavit. And the words of precedents have laid out that with or without an affidavit, it does not deny the party audience in court. The second respondent does not have an affidavit on record. He still has audience by way of points of law.
Does he intend to file one or not?
We don't intend to file an affidavit on reply for him. Because none of the paragraphs in the application have implicated IGP as a person. For him, we shall submit on points of law regarding matters pertaining to the second respondent. And so I humbly pray that the prayer by my land friend is misplaced, we shall limit ourselves on matters of law as it pertains matters with IGP, unless any other evidence is adduced in support of it. If it is the evidence on this application, which is an affidavit of Honorable Kyagulanyi, we shall submit on points of law. As regards the second African respondent, we so humbly pray.
So according to you, this application does not affect the second respondent?
I've not come across any evidence by any paragraph in it that implicates the IGP as a person in this application. And we shall submit on points of law regarding the second respondent.
It has been agreed that the error is the same after
the. Your Worship, Section 101 and 102 of the Evidence Act provides that who alleges must prove. So if they fail to prove in their affidavit, we can submit it as a point of law as regards the second respondent. That's what we intend to do.
In light of that, I am okay with him proceeding that way. Without his client's evidence. And now, having been served in court with the 6 affidavits, we pray for time to make rejoinders there too. We are also praying for leave in accordance with Order 19, Rule 3 of the Civil Procedure Rules to have one Tobacco Juliet Topacho Juliet to be cross-examined on some matters which we feel need. Of the following, Topacho Juliet, where is it in Ganesi? Barasa Ogajo.
That's the third?
Yes, the third.
The fourth?
Yes. Kato Arafat, 7. And George Mwonda, Mutumba. We have some serious questions which we need them to clarify. And therefore pray for the earliest date possible, preferably with your permission. Worship next week, considering the nature of the case. We feel we need them, and with your permission, we would have filed our rejoinders by Monday next week, which would be 24th. It's very therefore that you find pleasure in giving us a guest next week. We suffer.
I have no stand. In the same vein, we move under the same rule, what the 19 rule 3, and we pray that the deponent of the affidavit and support will appear for cross examination on that date. As regards matters pertaining to affidavits, it's so. Secondly, Your Worship, we also have points of law raised as regards as pertains to this application, and we shall quickly raise them on that day that shall avail us. We so humbly pray.
Your Worship, on cross examination for the applicant, we have no objection. Points of law, we equally would have no objection, except the rules of pleading require that you indicate that you indicate your objection in issue, and we shall respond anyway.
Worship, we would also pray that if you consider a date, you will consider morning, because you might have a long day given the need to cross examine the departments.
Given that both counsel would like to cross-examine several deponents, This court hereby orders that the applicant, as well as the partial jury, the third respondent, fourth respondent, sixth respondent, and seventh respondent, attend court on the 26th of August at 9 a.m. for cross-examination and hearing of this application. This matter is according to the 26th August and hearing at 9 a.m.
Kwa Yes. We thank you for being a very serious man.
Thank you. Thank you.